Good morning. In our previous session, we have seen the binary tree and the representation of the binary tree. Today, we are going to study about the binary tree traversal techniques. There are three different ways by which we can traverse a binary tree, that is pre-order, in-order and post-order. The root decides the traversal sequence. If the root comes first, then in the traversal sequence, then it is called as pre-order traversal. If the root comes in between, then it is called as in-order traversal sequence. If the root comes at the last, it is called as post-order traversal sequence. Now we'll see all these traversal sequences with examples one by one. Now we'll see the first method to traverse a binary tree, that is called as pre-order traversal. There are three steps into the algorithm. The first step is, we first of all visit the root node, that is V. Then after visiting the root node, we visit the left subtree in pre-order fashion, that is L. Third is, we visit the right subtree in pre-order sequence. This is a recursive algorithm, so we repeat all the above steps till the last node is traversed. To remember the pre-order traversal algorithm, we use this shortcut, that is V, L and R. In this case, V is the root node, L is the left subtree and R is the right subtree. Now we'll see the first example on traversal of binary tree using pre-order traversal method. Consider this is the binary tree given to you, and suppose we want to traverse this tree using pre-order traversal sequence. Then we first of all write the shortcut that we had defined for pre-order traversal on top of every node, VLR, that we write on top of each and every node. Now during our traversal, we start our traversal from the root node. Whenever there is V comes into the traversal sequence, it means we have to cut the V, and whatever may be the value inside the node must be returned into the pre-order traversal sequence. So we write A here because we got V first. So we cut V and then we write A here. After cutting V, the next alphabet is L. It indicates that we must go to left subtree to visit the left subtree root node. So towards left hand side we have node B, but on top of node B also we have a VLR sequence. Here we cut V and then we write B into the pre-order traversal sequence. Then we go to the L, but there is no left subtree for node B, so we cut L. There is also no right subtree for node B, so we cut R also. So it means that the left subtree of node A visiting is over, so we cut L also here. Then only R is remaining. It indicates that go to the right subtree. When you go to the right subtree, there is node C, and on top of node C we have written VLR. Now we cut V and we write C into the pre-order traversal sequence. Then there is L, so we go to the left subtree, and the left subtree node is D. On top of it also we have written VLR, so we cut V now and we write D into the pre-order traversal sequence. There is no left subtree and there is no right subtree to the node D, so we cut L as well as R here. It means that the left subtree traversal part is over for node C, so we cut L here, and there is no right subtree for node C, so we cut R also. At last we cut the R part of node A. At the end we can say that this is the pre-order traversal sequence. If you notice here, the root node A is coming at the beginning of the traversal sequence. It means that this is the root node of the tree, and always the root node comes at the beginning of the pre-order traversal sequence. So this is the final traversal sequence for the given diagram, that is ABCD for this ring. Now we'll see another traversal technique, that is in order. In order traversal method, the algorithm consists of three steps, that is, we visit the left subtree in order. After that, we visit the root node, that is V, and at last we visit the right subtree in in-order fashion. This is also a recursive algorithm, and we repeat all the above steps till the last node is traversed. Consider this is the binary tree given to you, and your task is to traverse this tree in in-order fashion. So the shortcut that we have decided for in-order traversal sequence is L, then V, and then R. It means first we go to the left subtree, then we visit root node, and at last we visit right subtree. So what we have to do is we will write the shortcut that we have decided on top of every node. LVR, LVR here, LVR here, LVR here. Okay. After that, we start our traversing from the root node. If you go to root node, the first alphabet that is coming into the shortcut is L. It indicates that you have to go to left subtree. When you go to node B, again on top of it there is LVR written, but there is no L, so we cut L. Then the next alphabet is V. When you cut V, we have to write B that is into the in-order traversal sequence. So the first node that we traverse in using this in-order traversal method is B. After that we go to R alphabet, but there is no right subtree to node B, so we cut R. It means that the left subtree traversal is over. After doing the left subtree traversal, we cut L. And then whenever V comes to V, we have to cut that alphabet V and we write the value of that node into the traversal sequence, that is here, into the in-order traversal sequence. Then there is R alphabet on top of A. We'll go to R subtree, that is to node C. There is again LVR written on top of it. It means it indicates that we have to go to left subtree of node C first. So there is another node, that is node D towards left hand side of C. On top of it also we have written LVR, but there is no left subtree to node D, so we cut L here. Then we cut V and we write D here after U. Then there is no right subtree to node D, we cut R here, and then it means that we have traversed the left subtree of node C, we cut L here. After cutting L, the next alphabet into the traversal sequence is V. We cut V and then we write C into the in-order traversal sequence. There is no right subtree to node C, so we cut R also. At last, we have traversed the right subtree also, so we cut R here. So this ends the in-order traversal sequence for this diagram. If you see in this in-order traversal sequence, the root node A is coming in between the sequence. It indicates that the root node is in between in in-order traversal. The last traversal method is post-order traversal. It also has three steps in it. The first step is we have to visit the left subtree in post-order. Then we visit the right subtree in post-order. At last we visit the root node. So the shortcut that we defined for the post-order traversal is L, R, V. It means first of all we have to visit left subtree, then right subtree, and at last visit the root node. For this given diagram, we have to write a post-order traversal sequence. So what we do is, we'll write the shortcut that we have decided, L, R, V, on top of every node here. Okay. Then we start our traversal from the root node. Whenever we go to root node, we found L. L means we have to go to left subtree. When you come to node B, again there is LVR written on top of node B. So there is no left and there is no right subtree to node B. So we cut L as well as R here. But whenever we cut V, we have to write the alphabet node value into the post-order traversal sequence. Now we cut V here and we write B into the post-order traversal sequence. After that, we go back to the node A because the left traversal is over. So we cut L. After visiting the left subtree, the next task is to go to right subtree because R is written here. So we go to right subtree. At node C, again we have written L, R, V here. So it means we have to go to left subtree here. We are at node D. Again on top of it, we have written L, R, V. But there is no left and there is no right subtree to node D. We cut L, R here. At last, we cut V here and we write D into the post-order traversal sequence. The left subtree traversal for this node is OR. So we go to its root node and we cut R because there is no right subtree for node C, and at last we cut V. Whenever we cut V here, we write C into the post order traversal sequence. Now if you see, the right subtree traversal is OR, so we cut R here, and at last we cut V also, and we write A into the post order traversal sequence. This is the end of the post order traversals for this given diagram. If you see into the post order sequence, the root node A is coming at the last. So this is the correct traversal sequence for the given diagram. So thank you for listening this video.